What is happening, troops? Welcome back to another video in the Shop Div YouTube channel. And I know that a lot of yous have been anticipating the return of a Rangers video, so I'm bringing you it right now for Rangers vs Hamilton fan preview. Video, if you don't mind, smash the like button if you're excited for them returning. I also want to announce that these are now on sale at Grieve Sports. I'm not too sure about JD, but I've seen on Twitter the day that they are now available at Grieve Sports, so you can pick up a Rangers top from an actual shop rather than doing it online. And also, I want to give a massive shout out to PLZ Soccer. I was actually on their show the other week speaking to Peter Martin about the Rangers and Villarreal game. This is a show that Barry Ferguson goes on, which you know, well, maybe you know, that he is my absolute footballing idol. When I was a wee guy, I tried to play like him very unsuccessfully, but he was a player when I was growing up that was a top boy, and they managed to get him to sign a wee photo from me, and they've sent it over. So thanks very much, Barry, and thanks very much, PLZ Soccer. Here it is, right here. Boom. Can't really see it, but Barry Ferguson right there. Signed to David, best wishes, and I've also put a wee message on the back saying "Watch up, Div on YouTube." Thanks very much for the bump in my heart, really appreciate it. So Rangers versus Hamilton. Hamilton are currently 9th in the league. They have got 2 wins to their name and 6 defeats. They've conceded 17 goals in the league and only managed to score 6. In the last encounter, they get absolutely annihilated off of Hibs at their stadium, 6-0. Can Rangers do any better? You let me know in the comments section below. Their only 2 wins of the season came a lot earlier on. The first one was 1-0 versus Motherwell away from home, which, in the grand scheme of things, isn't that impressive. The other was a 3-0 home victory versus St Mirren, and again, it's coming against lesser teams, teams that are struggling severely in the SPFL. When they've came up against a good team, they have been annihilated. They've been beat 4-1 versus Hearts at home, they've been beat 6-0 away, and they've been beaten by Celtic slenderly as well though, so that was probably one of their better performances when they get beat 1-0. You know it's a bad day when like Dougie Imrie is one of your best players, but I've identified 2 players that I think could potentially be a threat for Rangers, and that is Bingham and Muller. Bingham is just a big guy and he's scored a goal or 2 this season, same with Muller. So they might be the goal threats for them. We just need to keep a close eye on them coming back for international break. We don't want to be rusty. We don't want a repeat of a Motherwell game or a Livingston game. We don't want none of that. So we need to keep an eye on some of their key players, shut them out of the game. And I'm very confident if we do that, then we'll be able to get a result. And we'll be laughing, we'll be singing, and we'll be dancing, and we'll be on our way to Baku. Now, before we do continue, I want to speak about a really serious matter, and that is about a tweet that I saw from a Hamilton fan, and it was addressing Hamilton and Rangers fans about the passing of a Rangers fan named Grant Armitage. Sorry if I'm not pronouncing that correctly, who died recently. Rest in peace to him. My thoughts go out to his family and his friends and his close people that obviously knew him. But Hamilton, a Hamilton supporter, put out a tweet the other day that I retweeted, and it was saying that there's going to be, in the 28th minute, a minute's applause. So if we can do that, Rangers fans and Hamilton fans, that would be immense. Shows great solidarity and respect. Now I'm going to move on to an issue that I actually do have with Hamilton, and that is the fact that they play in a plastic pitch. I don't believe in plastic pitches, especially in the top tier of the Scottish leagues. I don't think that it should be in place. We've saw that with Jamie Murphy, we've learned the hard way that these pitches can cause serious injuries. 67% greater chance of picking up an ACL injury if you're playing on a plastic pitch as opposed to a grass pitch. So it's a very worrying statistic, that one. So in my opinion, these pitches should be banned. We need to do something about this, honestly. But that's not actually kept us from doing well on these pitches. In the last 2 meetings, we've scored 9 goals versus them. I was actually at the last away game where I think we won 5-3. Josh Winda scored a hat-trick and we were flying. So that leads me on to my prediction for this match, and hold your hats, because it's going to be a high one. My prediction for the Rangers versus Hamilton game, an away game actually, and we all know that Rangers have been struggling away, but one team is due a pumping, and I think it's going to be Hamilton. I'm going very high. I'm going Rangers 7, Hamilton 1. I'm giving them a goal just for a wee bit of security, honestly, but it might even be 7-0. Now, I know I'm going out there with my prediction, we might end up not coming anywhere close to that, and I'm going to look like an idiot, but that's the whole part of doing a prediction. Let me know what you think in the comments section below, and also fancy wee Morelos to get himself a hat-trick. Come on, the Rangers. Moving on to the team that I think will start versus Hamilton, and I'm going to go with a similar team that's been starting in a lot of the games, but the fact that Lafferty is actually potentially going to be missing it. Sky Sports have like said that he will miss it, and Super Scoreboard said that he potentially will miss it because the Irish FA, the Northern Irish FA, have put a ban on him playing. They've enforced the 5-day UEFA rule due to him pulling out of the Northern Ireland squad and playing for Rangers in the previous match. He won't be able to play in this match, so that'll be unfortunate if he's not able to make the squad. And another rumour that I'm hearing is Arfield may have picked up an injury, so I'm going to take him out of my starting 11 as well. I'm going to go Alan McGregor in goals, right back Tavernier, two centre-backs will be Goldson and Worrall, but I wouldn't be surprised if Gerrard threw a spanner in the box and just threw Katic in for this one. I think Flanagan will continue at left-back, he's been exceptional in the last two games, but maybe Barisic will come in, we'll just wait and see. We're playing a lesser team, we may want to be more attacking, but I think Flanagan deserves to still be in that team. I'm putting Ryan Jack back into the starting 11 beside Koulibaly, but Koulibaly is another maybe for me because we've seen his performance versus Livingston, which was on a plastic pitch, so they may put someone else in there, but Koulibaly, I think, can do the job. In front of that, we're going to Jaya, who is a player, just came back from injury, he's finding his feet again, but before his injury, he was playing exceptionally. On the right-hand side, Candace, a revitalised player since the start of the season, technically so better, works, compliments Tav a lot because he tracks back so much and helps him out. Up front, we're going for the Buffalo. Morelos, fancy him to get a good few goals in this game, do what he does best and score goals. And on left wing, the player in form, Ryan Kent. Come on, wee man, continue your good form. Let me know what you think in the comment section below. Will Rangers hammer Hamilton? Will Hamilton surprise Rangers? Will they step their game up versus us? And what do you think that the starting 11 should be or will be in this match? There's my prediction. There is my team lineup that I expect or maybe want to start in this match versus Hamilton. And I want to know yours, as I just said, in the comment section below. If you've enjoyed this video and you want to see more, then subscribe to the channel, like it because it helps the video get out there into the algorithm of YouTube's, and I'll see you in the next one. I've been Sharp Div, you've been you, mate, or mate, Ty, plural, and I'm out. All my weakness keep on leaning.